that is known as gravitation. So what is gravitation? It is the pull of Earth or towards the Earth. There is a pull for any objects that is falling on it. So let's start with the slide. So what is gravitation? It is a force of attraction between two objects in the universe. So across the universe, whatever objects is there, that is pulled towards the gravitation force of the Earth. So let's understand it. Gravitation is attraction of objects by the Earth. So Earth pulls off the objects towards it. That is known as gravitation. So you can imagine dropping a ball from a height or any object from a height. It falls downwards to the Earth's gravity because Earth pulls it towards it. If a body is thrown upwards also, if you throw a ball upwards also, after some time it will be coming down. So it reaches certain height and it will fall again towards the Earth by the Earth's gravity. So gravitation may be attraction between objects that is on the Earth and also with the outer space. So attraction between Earth and Moon, attraction between Sun and the other planets can be taken as some examples. So what is centripetal force? The force that is to the center. So you can imagine a stone tied to a thread. The thread, at the end of the thread, you rotated the stone in a circular movement. So in a circular movement, after some time, you release the thread. It moves in a straight line. So that is known as centripetal force. So let's see that when a body moves in a circular path, it changes its direction at every point. So the force which keeps the body in circular path acts towards the center of the circle. So the body will keep towards the center of the circle, and the force of this is known as centripetal force. If there is no centripetal force, the force is not there and you release the object, you can see that the body will move in a straight line tangent to the circular path. So moving on to the next one, let's understand the universal law of gravitation. So all the universal law of gravitation is based on the second law of motion with respect to Newton. So here the universal law of gravitation states that every object in the universe attracts each other. So attracts each other and with the force. So it has some force and it will attract each other, which is directly proportional to the product of its masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two objects. So you can see here, let's take an example of two objects, A and B, having mass. So mass of first object is capital M, mass of second object is small letter m. And you can see that they are lying at a distance d from each other. So what is the force here? Force is F, that is force of attraction. You can see the arrow mark towards each other. It's the force of attraction. So what is it according to law of gravitation say? So law of gravitation says that the force between the two objects is directly proportional. So it is directly proportional to the product of their masses, to the product of the masses. So it's directly proportional to the product of the masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, that is d square. So how it is written as? F is directly proportional to m into n. M and F is directly or inversely proportional to 1 by d square. So inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So combining the two equations, so this equation and this equation, you can see that F is directly proportional to M and by d square. So F is also related to the gravity. So F is equal to g for gravitation into M, that is product of the masses by square of the distance between them. So where g is constant here, proportionality, which is known as universal gravitational constant. So cross multiplying it, we get F into d squares. So it is distance and forces cross multiplied. F into d square is equal to gmm. So you can also write as g is equal to F into d square by mm. So here the SI unit of G or gravitation constant is Newton meter square per kg square. And its value is, what is its value? So G gravitation value is 6.673 into 10 to the power of 11 Newton meter square per kg square. So moving on to the next one. So what is a free fall? So any object from a distance or a height, it falls to the ground. So the earth attracts objects towards itself to the gravitational force. So when an object falls from a height, you can see that it moves towards the earth. And this gravitational force that pulls the object is known as the free fall. So when an object falls towards the earth, there is a change in acceleration. So you can see that due to gravitational force, the change in acceleration here is known as acceleration due to gravity. So A was represented in the chapter of motion as acceleration. Here it is acceleration is with respect to the gravity. So acceleration due to gravity is denoted by small g. So gravitation constant is denoted by capital letter G. So here you can see the unit of G, that is acceleration due to gravity, is same as the unit of acceleration. So unit of acceleration is also meter per second, and unit of acceleration due to gravity is also meter per second. From the second law of motion, force, what is force? Force equals m into a, that is mass into acceleration. It is product of mass and acceleration. So F is equal to ma for free fall. What is free fall? Force is the product of mass and acceleration due to gravity. So F is equal to ma is replaced by m into g, or it can be written as mg is equal to g into mm by d square, and g is equal to gm by d square. So what is m here? M is the mass of, where m is the mass of the earth and d is the distance between the object and the earth. So m represents the mass of the earth and d represents the distance between the object and the earth. For objects which is near, very near to the surface of the earth, so d, distance is equal to the radius of the earth, which is known as r. So here you can see that g is equal to gm m by r square. And the value of G, that is acceleration due to gravity, is 9.8 meter per second. So moving on to the next one. So what is mass? Let's move on to the mass. So mass of the body will remain same, but weight of any body will keep on changing. So why so? We will understand. The mass of the body is the measure of inertia. So mass of the body is more when inertia is more, and you can see mass of the body is constant. It does not change from one place to another. SI unit of mass is kg or kilogram. Next we'll move on to the weight. So weight of the body is the force. It is a force with which earth attracts the body. Any body that is attracted towards the earth represents the weight. So you can see that the force with which a body is attracted on the earth depends on its mass and acceleration due to gravity. So F is equal to m into g. Since weight of a body is force of the earth attracts to body, so weight, so F is replaced by W and m into g. So weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. Since g, that is acceleration due to gravity, at a place is constant, weight is directly proportional to the mass. The weight of the body will change from place to place, but mass will remain same. The SI unit of weight is same as the force. What is the force unit? It is Newton, and here also the SI unit of weight is Newton. Newton is represented as capital letter N. So moving on to the next slide. So weight of an object on the moon. So we have spoken about the weight of the object on Earth. But now we need to speak about the weight of the object or moon. So as it is told that the weight can change from one place to another, weight of an object on Earth is the force with which Earth will attract towards itself. But here you can see the mass of the moon is less than the mass of the Earth. You can see that the moon exerts less force on the objects. So that's why the objects float so low. So you can see that the weight of an object on the moon is 1/6 of its weight of the Earth. So 1/6 time the weight is less of the moon when compared to the Earth. So coming on to the next one, what is thrust and pressure? So thrust, you can see that thrust is the force which acts on an object perpendicular to the surface. So for example, you go and stand on a sand or a beach. So where you have a lot of sand there, and wherever you put the leg, your leg goes deep inside it. So that is known as thrust. But what happens when you slip over the sand? So there is equal body force and the weight that is applied on the sand. So the whole body will not go inside the sand. So when you stand on loose sand, the force or the weight of your body is acting on area which is equal to the area of your feet. So your feet only will be on the sand and the whole body weight will go to the sand. And that's why you can observe that your leg or the feet gets inside the sand. When you lie down, the same force acts on the area of the contact area of whole body. So that's why in both the cases, force acting on the sand, it is known as thrust, will remain the same. Next, coming on to pressure. So what is pressure? Pressure is force acting on unit area of a surface. So how do you denote it? Pressure equals to thrust by area. So what is the example here? Again, it is the loose sand. Here larger, it is larger while standing than while lying down. So SI unit of thrust is Newton per meter square and it is denoted as Pascal or Pa. So going on to the next one, pressure in fluids, that is liquids and gases. So fluids also exert, you can see that any container, if you fill water into it, the water will exert pressure over the walls of the container. And the walls also equally put pressure on the water. So you can see here the pressure exerted on the base or walls of the container. Fluids exert pressure in all the directions in the container. So pressure exerted on fluid is transmitted equally in all directions. So fluid will exert pressure equally on all the directions. So what is buoyancy? It is upthrust. So what is upthrust here? You can see when an object here, taking an example of buoyant force, an object is immersed in a fluid, it experiences. So when you drop an object, immediately the object, if it is not too heavy, you can see that it goes to some extent down and it will again bounce back. So it is known as this force, upward force is known as buoyant force. This property is known as buoyancy or it is also known as upthrust. So force of gravity, here you can see that it is against the gravity, even force of gravity also pulls it down. So you can see object downward and buoyant force will pulls it up. So two wave forces applied here. The magnitude of buoyant force depends on the density of the fluid. It depends on the density, how denser the fluid is. Here, based on that, the object moves. So coming on to the next one. So why objects float or sink in water? If the density of object is less, when compared to the liquid, you can see that it will float on the liquid. If the density of object is more than the liquid, you can see that the object will sink down. And based on the activity, let's see one activity. Take some water in a beaker, take a piece of cork, and an iron nail of same mass. So same mass, you are taking two objects. One is the cork and one is the nail. So place them in water. you can see that cork will float and the nail will be at the bottom of the beaker. So why it happens? The cork floats because here density of water is more than the cork and density of cork is less than the water. So upthrust of water is more than the weight of the cork, hence it floats. The nail sinks because nail's density is more than the water used here. So the upthrust of water, the pulling force of the water is less, and you can see that weight of the nail is more, hence the nail goes down and settles down in the beaker. So coming on to the next. So Archimedes' principle. Archimedes' principle, what does he see? So he had observed that, so one day he went into a bathtub. A bathtub was filled almost with water. He just entered into the bathtub. He could see that the water spilled out. So he was so happy. He shouted, "Eureka, I have found it." So what was that he found? So when a body is partially or fully immersed in fluid, it experiences upward force and the water spills out. So you might have also done some experiments at home. So bucket filled with water, you might have put your hand or leg inside and you might have seen the water rising up. It is because of the upward force. And this weight of the fluid is displaced by the force of the object on it. So here, Archimedes' principle has many uses. What is the use? It is used for designing ships, submarines, hydrometers, and also density of liquids like lactometers, which is used to test the purity of the milk. So coming on to the next one, density and relative density. So what is density? It is the mass of unit volume of any substance. So what is density? Density is mass by volume. The unit of density is kilogram per meter cube. So relative density. Relative density of any substance is the ratio of the density of a substance. Density of a substance is the ratio of density with respect to the density of water. Density of a substance by density of water is known as relative density. So you can see that relative density is ratio of similar or same quantities if it has no unit. So it doesn't have any unit and the ratio is with similar quantities. So that's all about this topic. So thank you all for watching.